I call the city of Dacono Monday, September 22nd, 2014, city council regular meeting to order and request a roll call, please.
Joe Baker.
Here.
Jen Schneider.
Here.
Nick Vogel.
Here.
Kevin Plain.
Here.
Peggy Randolph.
Present.
Robin Dunlap.
Here.
Charles Sigmund.
Present. We have a quorum of staffs and ask those in the audience to join us in the pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. All right. Public comments on issues not scheduled on tonight's agenda. I know I've got at least one, maybe two.
At least one, for sure.
All right.
No, I think you got two.
No. Three, all right.
Okay, I'm Linda Eastman. I think most of you know who I am. I'm here just to kind of... I don't think she's...
You need her address for...
Oh, 308 Glen Air Street, Dacono. I'm just here to share some of my concerns about some activity that is occurring just east of County Road 15 and just north of Grandview Avenue. And I've gone on and I've looked and seen what the review process is and everything at the county. And I understand there's little we can do about what's going on that side. But I suppose, you know, it's possible there could be some comment either from the city itself or definitely from some of us who are going to be impacted directly by this. But one of my big concerns is the road and the traffic that's going to be going on there is, should he get approved. There's a lot of trucks that will be going up and down that road. And from what I understand, they could be very heavy with dirt, trucking type dump trucks and things like that. So that is a road that we have to take care of in this city as far as maintaining it and the costs and any repairs or chips and seal or anything. So I'm a little concerned about that impact on the city and the budget regarding that. The other thing is if you look at the location of this place, it could very easily choose to also go down Grandview because it's just about on the corner of Grandview and Colorado 15. So it could be accessing and using Grandview, which again, you've got a dirt road. So there's some potential there for some severe road damage. So I'm wondering if that has been brought up or discussed. You know, is there anything, any comment that could be made to the county about those concerns and those expenses that may potentially fall on the city? The other thing is where they've done the drainage part of it. The stormwater drainage is quite an area that he's going to have on the northwest corner of the property, and it's going to abut right on County Road 15 as well. So what if we have a lot of rain that fills up and overflows into County Road 15 also? So those are two things I'm a little concerned about when I look at this, and I just wanted to bring it up. I don't know what we can do as a city in comment or anything. I do know there's an open case on it and the county is welcoming any comment.
Well, I know exactly what you're talking about because I know I've been contacted about this particular issue. The thing is, we got to keep in mind, like I said, everything on the east side of 15 is Well County. Yes, it is in Dacono's planning area, but just, you know, planning area is where we just draw out lines, you know, of what we plan on developing. The thing is, what I would encourage if the residents there see somebody, you know, or hear somebody using a jake brake or whatever, to make notification of what truck that was, mm-hmm. meaning, you know, see if you see a name on the side of the truck, the DOT number, because the DOT number is specific to that particular trucking line. Unfortunately, you know, because of budgeting and stuff like that, can't put an officer out there all day to wait for those particular violations. And of course, as you know, that's pretty wide open there.
Right.
So if we did put an officer, everybody abides the rules
right
when they see them.
Yes.
And then short of knowing what the weight of those particular trucks are, short of putting a portable scale and stuff like that, which is unfortunately at this point in time not in the city's means of being able to afford something like that. But we will make note, and we can make comment to Will County, let them know that these are some legitimate concerns we have at this particular place.
I think that would be appreciated by many of us, especially when you look at the potential for the road damage, you know, both on County Road 15 as well as Grandview with all that trucking going on. And it's not just they go out during the day and they come back at the end of the day. It's pretty active from what I understand.
Yeah, because I know I spend a little bit of time out there myself.
Yeah. And I did drive down and I did see that they patched, but a patch is a patch, you know. What's the future potential for damage and the impact on us budget-wise too? Yeah.
Exactly. Okay. Something we'll be definitely looking at. We'll be watching.
Okay, thanks.
All right. Thank you. Who else would like to speak this evening?
Hi, Amber Clay, 2281 WCR 10 over in Erie. I'm here to talk about Proposition 105 that we're very concerned with, especially in the agriculture community. We have a family farm over in Erie, and we do a majority of our work that we do is for the dairies over here in Fort Lupton area, but we do a lot of smaller jobs for other family farms. And Proposition 105 is a GMO labeling bill that demands to have a 0% threshold on GMOs. That would personally impact me and farmers like myself, in that the 0% threshold is very unrealistic, and it would create a demand for us to have to buy a whole separate piece of equipment, and as well as other storage facilities just for that non-GMO product, as we grow GMO product crops and non-GMO products. So that would increase costs that we of course would have to infer onto the consumer, which of course is you and me. This labeling measure demands that even products that have no detectable GMO protein, such as sugar, that are derived from sugar beets, they are to have a GMO label. However, products such as cheese and milk and meat that from animal products or animals that eat GMOs crops, they don't have to have the label. So the anti-GMO groups say that they want truth in labeling, and that's kind of hard to understand, where's the truth? With that, they also say that they have the right to know. In existence right now, there is non-GMO verified as well as organic, certified organic. And those labels would contradict with Proposition 105. Also required, food that you buy in 7-Eleven, such as soda, it doesn't have to be labeled, but the same exact product that you buy at King Soopers does have to be labeled. Gum doesn't have to be labeled. Doesn't make sense. So I'm confused. I don't know about you. And so with that, it would also add at least $400 to the average consumer or average family of four. And so with that, of course, families that use food stamps to buy their food, that they would be hit the hardest. And then it's estimated that taxpayers would also have to pay $22.5 million a year just for the staff and making sure that people are following the rules. So I appreciate your time. And just in conclusion, just that Proposition 105, we just feel is really costly and it's dangerous. It's unclear and confusing, and it's a very bad idea for Dacono and, of course, Colorado. And with that.
Thank you.
Well, good evening, honorable members of council and mayor. I'm Lori Sain. I live at 326 Jackson Avenue in Firestone, Colorado, 80520. I'm also here to urge you to help us in this endeavor to educate about Proposition 105. Recently, in a blue book hearing on the language of 105, the language was changed from may increase costs to will increase costs. And the average that was batted around in there was $8 per person. Well, if you're a single mother with three children, for example, that's a lot of money. So who are we trying to protect here? One of the articles that was recently released was in Forbes magazine, and one of the organizers, he works for a large organic company, says, we have to label it in order to organize against it. Now, what does that say? Right now we've got organic labeling, and if you want to buy organic and want to have that choice, you can purchase organic, which does not include GMO, and it's also pesticide free. So what's interesting about that is consumers already have a choice. And as Amber said, she mentioned that how much that cost will increase. It could be up to $400 and $500 per family. And Weld County currently has a larger percentage point, 2 percentage points higher for folks that are underneath the poverty level than the rest of Colorado. So this particular initiative would also not only be misinformation to the consumer, but also increase costs to everyone in Colorado, especially those that we say we care about the most, those who are economically disadvantaged. The other thing to consider as well, one of the questions that often comes up is, well, if it's just a label and food is mostly labeled, then what's the problem? The problem is this. Farmers like Amber would have to separate everything. That includes shipping, storage, transportation, and think about the Weld County and the Colorado farmers who will now have to compete against other states like Nebraska and Kansas corn, who wouldn't have to do the same thing. So there'd be a huge economic disadvantage, and those costs will be passed along to the consumer. That is a fact, and that's why the language in the Blue Book hearing was changed to reflect that. So if we could, what we're asking for folks to do, especially on city councils and mayors, if you could help us in this endeavor, one of those ways is to use your voice in editorials or in your city newsletter. If you could educate folks about the consequences of Proposition 105. Because right now that will increase costs for Colorado consumers, and I think Amber and I both agree that's really bad for Colorado. So thank you for your time this evening. Do you have any questions?
All right. Well, thank you so much for
coming. Thank you so much. It's nice to see you again.
Yes, good seeing you. It's a little different seeing you on that side over there.
It's a little bit different, yes.
Yeah, definitely.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
See you. Thank you.
Thanks, Laura. Good seeing you.
Is there any other public comments on issues not scheduled on tonight's agenda? All right, I'm seeing none. All right, we're now to our consent agenda, which consists of the minutes of the September 8, 2014 regular meeting, accounts payable dated September 22nd, 2014, in the amount of $490,685.80. Approval of Resolution 14-46, approving publishing agreement with the Colorado Code Publishing Company for Municipal Code Services. Approval of Resolution 14-74, approving a contract with Northern Colorado Contractors for water and storage drainage improvements on Summit Boulevard. Approval of the expenditures of the amount of $26,071 for Ferguson Waterworks and $14,512 to Mountain States Pipeline and Supply for materials for the Summit Boulevard project. Approval of Resolution 14-48, approving an agreement between the Douglas County Board of Commissioners and the Dacono Police Department regarding store. Then approval of the 2015 CIRSA insurance renewal. And approval of Resolution 14-49, granting final acceptance of the public improvements for split rail fence. All right. Council, what would you like to do with these particular items on tonight's consent agenda?
Move to approve as presented.
Okay, we have a motion made by Joe.
Second.
Seconded by Nick. Can I receive a vote on that, please?
Joe?
Yes.
Jen?
Yes.
Nick?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Peggy?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
All right, that motion carries with all voting yes. We now to our general business of the evening. First item is a public hearing of Resolution 14-50, approving an industrial land use for cutting edge steel. So at this time, I go ahead and I'm opening up the public hearing and turning it over to Jennifer.
Mayor and Council, this is the public hearing for resolution number 14-50, an application for an industrial use for cutting edge steel. The municipal zoning code requires that all industrial uses receive approval from the city council prior to occupancy. This is not a zoning amendment or a special use permit, but rather an evaluation of the proposed use to make sure that when it's operating, it will not create any excessive dust, noise, odor, vibration, etc. on adjacent properties. The applicant this evening is Cutting Edge Steel. They will be occupying the building currently owned or operated by Steel Star at 101 Miller Drive in the Grand Divide Business Park, just on the west side of County Road 13. Items that should be entered into the public hearing record this evening include the application for industrial use dated August 21st, 2014, the staff report dated September 22nd, 2014, and the Dacono Municipal Code. As I indicated, the property is located at 101 Miller Drive in Dacono, Colorado. It is currently zoned I-1 industrial use, and the surrounding land use within that industrial park is also I-1 industrial. Previously, City Council did approve the site development plan and industrial use for Steel Star by resolution 05-42. And again, the applicant this evening, Cutting Edge Steel, is requesting industrial use approval for metal fabrication of structural and miscellaneous metals, including cutting, welding, grinding, and applying primer coat. Staff did not contact referral agencies for this particular application. The building official and Mountain View Fire Rescue will conduct standard inspections prior to occupancy. Staff is recommending approval, as well as the Planning and Zoning Commission recommended approval by PC Resolution 14-07, finding that the industrial use is compatible with surrounding land use in the area and that the reoccupancy of the existing structure will not create any type of offensive noise, odor, dust, vibration, etc. to adjacent properties. Are there any questions?
Is there any questions for Jennifer at this time? Thank you. Does the applicant wish to speak at this time?
Sure.
All right. So what I'm going to have you do is see Belle there. She's going to swear you in and state your name and address.
Please state your name and address.
Jim Weaver, Cutting Edge Steel, 6292 Colorado Boulevard, Commerce City, Colorado, 80022.
Can you please raise your right hand? Do you swear or affirm that the testimony you're about to give before the Cone City Council will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do. The thing that most people probably don't know is that I used to occupy that building several years ago as a CEO of Steel Star Corporation. So I'm very familiar with the building. I'm somewhat familiar with Dacono from being here. And my business now is mainly stairs and rails and miscellaneous metals for the construction industry. And I'm happy to have the opportunity to come back and be into that facility and dress it up a little bit more.
Would you mind telling council maybe what are your plans maybe for sprucing up the property?
Well, the fence needs fixed for one, and there's a lot of weeds on the property, that kind of thing, that need dressed up. And you can see the heavy use that's out there if anybody who drives by. We're not quite as messy as you might see what's going on right there now. But I like to keep things neat and clean, and I like customers to see something nice when they come in. So I would suspect that you'll see some improvements there.
Dacono, we talked at the Planning Commission and that, but you know, we've set our standards a lot higher and that, and we'd like to see a real nice product and things like that. So it's great to hear that you want to take care of that fence and weed control out there.
Mm-hmm.
It's great to hear that. Council, you have some questions?
Sounds like you're just doing the same thing that they were doing, only a little bit better, so that's about all I have to say. Thanks, Jim.
Anyone else?
Thank you. Look forward to having a quality product. All right. Is there anyone from the public that wishes to speak on this matter? Okay, seeing none. So at this time, I close the public hearing and turn it back over to council. Like I said, we heard from the applicant. He's planning on, you know, coming in, cleaning the place up, making it look presentable,
start setting the standards for that particular area, which is great to hear. So, looks like he's doing what he needs to do, in my opinion. So, Council, what would you like to do with this particular matter?
I move to approve Resolution 1450, approving an application for industrial use for cutting-edge steel.
Okay, I have a motion made by Jen.
Second.
Seconded by Peggy. Can I receive a vote, please?
Jen?
Yes.
Nick?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Peggy?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Joe?
All right.
Yes.
All right. That motion carries with all voting yes. Welcome to Dacono, and we look forward to having you here. I know it's a little bit of a process, but we want to make sure you get everybody, you know, up to the right standard there. All right. Next item of business is consideration of Resolution 14-51, approving the water dedication assistance policy for LGI homes. Jennifer, can I be the presenter on this?
Council, this is the first water dedication assistance agreement that is being presented to you. By way of background, for those of you who were perhaps not on the council in July of this year, the City Council approved Resolution 14-29, which established a water dedication assistance policy. The idea behind the policy is that the cost of raw water was increasing at such a rate that it was becoming an impediment to development in the city of Dacono. The City Council authorized or created a policy whereby the city could sell some of its own water via cash in lieu to local home builders or developers at a rate that was currently below market rate. Market rate based on the last, I believe it was July CBT sales, was at about $24,000. You put that together with the cost of a water tap and you're looking at about $35,388 before you ever put a shovel in the ground. So based upon the price point of homes that are currently selling in the city of Dacono, the numbers just weren't working for many home builders. You have in your packet this evening a request for water dedication assistance from LGI Homes Colorado. They are a home builder that is entering the Colorado market, and Dacono was one of the first communities that they are actually going to be building in. They are requesting to purchase 59 units of CBT for the Legacy Park subdivision. In your report, you have a very long history about Legacy Park. It is located at State Highway 52 and County Road 11, and there is nothing there but finished pad sites, and you might see like a white fence when you drive by it. I'll just kind of summarize what basically the staff report says about the subdivision. That is, it's taken 10 years, but there's a home builder that wants to build there. And they are requesting, again, 59 units. The water dedication assistance policy provides for up to a 25% discount. So staff is recommending the cash in lieu amount be $18,000, which is about 25% below market. If you recall the policy, in exchange for that water benefit, we have asked potential applicants to provide a subdivision enhancement, whether that be in the form of additional recreation amenities, landscaping, or other upgrades to the subdivision. And LGI Homes has presented an enhanced landscaping plan and an enhanced monument sign for the subdivision, valued at about $65,000 worth of enhancements. So we feel that the city is getting something back in exchange to make the subdivision a little bit more desirable, perhaps, to some of these potential home buyers. The policy also sets forth some rules that says basically they have to purchase all of the water within 90 days. They need to pay for it. They have to use it within 18 months. It cannot be transferred outside of the city or to another project. That way, obviously, we know that water that the city has purchased is staying within the city. You do have an agreement in your packet this evening, which lays out these conditions and has been signed by LGI Homes. Staff is recommending approval of this resolution, finding that, based upon the cost of water, that we feel that this will certainly help spark some additional development within the city. We don't feel that this sale or this transfer will be detrimental to any of the residents currently in the city of Dacono. They are in compliance. LGI Homes is in compliance with the development agreement, and at your last council meeting, you did approve an assignment of that agreement. And that they have, LGI Homes has provided additional subdivision enhancements that we feel are acceptable, and therefore staff is recommending approval of Resolution 14-51. Are there any questions?
This isn't so much a question. What it is I more of a comment. I see this working to help spur growth within the community and also to give the quality products that Dacono's looking for in our community to continue to grow where we want to be. So it's definitely a great idea to get these stale communities that we've had on the back burner for the last, you know, 10 to 15 years, some of them. It's definitely something to get them going.
Mayor, I just have a statement and a question. First, I totally agree. I think it's a win-win. It's a good use of the units, and it gets a little something extra and gets activities going from developers that we'd like to see. But just a quick question about the 18 months. So if they, for whatever reason, they've already purchased it, the 18 months pass, they're not at full build-out as anticipated, what happens?
So the policy authorizes a one-time extension if they need it. And if they can't use it within that time period, the city gets them back, if you will. The money that they're paying for is held in escrow, and the agreement provides for the city to be able to make draws on those funds as building permits are issued. So the money will be sitting there until they actually physically use the building permits to construct. So what they don't use, we would refund the money to the city, and they would have to go out to the market and purchase water at market rate and complete their water dedication obligation before any more permits would be issued.
Okay. That sparks one more question, I guess. CBT rates, we don't anticipate that going up dramatically in the next 18 months, do we? I hope
we're talking water.
Yeah, it's hard to tell. We're very fortunate that our water attorney provides us with current rates, and if you look at the last few months, they've been increasing they certainly haven't gone down.
Okay.
Depends on the cost.
Yeah, I just don't want to get the city caught in a bad situation if you know, they purchase the water, and I don't know. We'll see.
Well, it sounds like the clock's running, because if it's taken 2.5 to 3.5 months to build a home, and there's 59 homes, and there's 18 months to buy 59 shares, it's only a matter of, time before they either get 59 homes built in 18 months or go out in the open market, and they're already further committed to finishing the homes anyway.
Sure.
Without going into too much detail about LGI, and unfortunately there's not a representative here this evening, they are based out of Arizona, so they don't really have a Colorado presence yet. The short version of, they are a production home builder, and it is not at all unusual, they said, for them to pull 8 building permits a month, and they have a, they refer to as a very unique sales strategy. And they build homes, and when you as a potential buyer go look at the home, that's the home you will potentially buy. It's not sort of, do you want, stainless steel or black, appliances. It's what you see is what you get. So they feel that they have a very aggressive and somewhat different sales strategy, and that they will not have any problems getting through those units. So we hope they're right.
Yeah, exactly. Hope so.
Wishing the best of luck.
Yeah. All right. Thank you.
Fantastic.
All right, Council, what would you like to do?
Move to approve Resolution 14-51, approving a water dedication assistance agreement for Legacy Park filing number 1.
All right.
Second.
Got a motion made by Joe, seconded by Jen. Can I please receive a vote?
Nick?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Peggy?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Joe?
Yes.
Jen?
Yes.
That motion carries, all voting yes. All right, fantastic. We are now through general business, and we are to our staff reports. AJ.
Keep it light, just a scheduling, quick schedule update. There's no planning commission meeting tomorrow, or are there any other official meetings the rest of this week? The next council meeting will be on October 13th. So there's a kind of a little break between meetings. So rest up, because I'm sure we'll have a lot to work on that night. We've been moving some things down, so I think they'll finally be ready for public consumption. I think that's about it. Unless there are any questions?
Any questions for AJ at this time? All right, great. Staff report. I mean, council reports. Ah, long day. It looks like Jen's got something,
yeah,
right? I'll let you go ahead.
So the Weld County Food Bank is in a contest right now where if you vote daily at this website, if they get the most votes, they get $60,000 to put towards the food bank. I talked to the representative. She said that they're going to put $45,000 to this Weld County Food Bank, the one that's right, that comes and visits, and the rest of it's going to go to Erie for the church that got destroyed in the flood. So for anybody that would like to, it's walmart.com/fighthunger, and then in the side it'll say Weld Food Bank, and that's the one you want to click, and you can vote daily. And that's open until October 5th, and they're really close. This is a contest between 50 other food banks around the country, and they're doing really good, so I'd really like them to get this money.
And we've also linked that on the city's Facebook page.
Perfect. Thanks.
So that you can just go there and click the links.
Thanks.
All right. Any other council reports?
I just wanted to thank Mountain View Fire Protection District for inviting the council to go to the ribbon cutting, neighbors to the north up in Mead. Thank you, Robin and Peggy, for showing up. It was kind of fun. It was an all-day event, pig roast. They had a fundraiser also for a food bank locally up there, and I think they raised about $800. People stood in line for quite some time, and they had all the chiefs out there serving food, which was interesting to see. So that's all I had. So, but thanks.
Any other council reports? Okay. I'd just like to just make a couple quick comments. You know, Dacono, I feel I'm really proud that Dacono's moving in the direction we are. You know, tonight on the general business, you know, it shows that we have some great quality products coming into Dacono. Even with us setting the bar higher than what it's ever been before, we're getting quality products coming into our community, making it more desirable for the outside. So I just hope we continue to maintain this rhythm that we have going, to make sure we continue to keep setting that bar up there. You know, I know, for example, cutting it in the edge steel, you know, it's one of those things they had to go through quite a process before they got to us today, you know, to make sure it is the quality business that we want to see back in the city of Dacono. And I truly believe they are going to bring a quality business to our community. Same thing with LG Homes. They're going to bring another quality product to our community. Something to be proud of. And then with the new water dedication, you know, we're getting, by offering that, we're getting off these stale communities. We want to make sure we can get those built out and make sure they're built out at a quality. You know, I can't say quality enough, because that was one of our biggest fallbacks back in the day. But now we have the right people in place, we're making it happen. So I want to thank everybody that's making that happen. So with that, I would entertain a motion to adjourn. If
so
there's
moved.
No further. All right, I have a motion made by Joe, second by Peggy. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All right, meeting adjourned.